Alright guys, today we're going to do another episode of the $5 Gamer, where I'm going to play X-Men and see if I can beat it with only $5. In this game, that means I have 30 lives. It's 3 lives per credit, and a credit's 50 cents, so it's 30 lives. Just want to leave you in a little secret. It is summertime in Minnesota, finally, and in celebration of this summer, I'm currently not wearing any pants. Go in full anchor mode. Only the top half, no pants down here, so. Imagine that while I'm playing. So I'm gonna get up to 30 lives. There we go. Turn up a bit. And then I'm gonna be Storm.
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 In the 21st century.
Do we want to watch the amazing story? Well, what happens is Magneto starts making a racket.
The only hope is,
and the X-Men have to stop him. Look at these Sentinels. Look how mean they are. Oh, X-Men. Look at this stylish green jacket he's got on. Only one X-Man is actually going. It's Storm. The rest are busy. Now, this is based, I mean, my biggest experience with X-Men is with the cartoon. And this is the old comic version, so Storm looks a little different than you might be used to. But this is what she used to look like back in the comic days. Which is pretty cool. I'm not sure if she ever had a baton, though. She has like a scepter. That's pretty cool. This game's kind of interesting the way it works with the powers. See, if you notice my life up there, the little blue ball that's like the blue orb, that's a special power that I have. Also, if I use a special power right now, it'll use 3 of my life bars, which is a considerable amount. You start with 10. Oh, he got me with it. I love these guys that bring the rocks. Like, this guy's got a bazooka, okay? Then the other guys, even though they're like, they're sentinels. They're made out of metal. They're giant robots made out of metal. They bring the boulders to drop them on me. Like, that's their... I mean, they got guys with bazookas. They ran out of guns. They had to bring guys with rocks. It's absurd. Why is this guy trying to charge me so hard? So, what was I saying? I was saying, okay, if I use my special power, it takes 3 of my life bars. Which is considerable. But then, if I have less than 3... Or, sorry, 3 or less, then I'll use my blue orb, okay? For free. Free, quote-unquote. If I'm low enough on life. It's desperation move. Now, if you die with a blue orb, you lose that blue orb. You don't get it back. So it's in your best interest to, like, kind of spam your power when you're low on life. It's a weird dynamic, kind of. So I'm not sure I feel about it. I'm thinking about it while I'm playing. Oh, God. So I really don't want to die. I want 2 lives left, which... Okay, good. I want to hit Pyro.
Pyro!
If you hit him in the corner, you kind of own him. Yeah, that kind of... He's weak. Look, I died 0 times on level 1. That's better than I usually do. And I feel pretty good about this run right now. Sentinels. These are little Sentinels. In the cartoon, like I said, I'm not a big comic book X-Men fan. In the cartoon, the Sentinels were always huge. And there was one huge Sentinel in this game later. But... I'm not sure where the small ones came from. Probably just for the video game, they had to make small ones because it's kind of absurd to fight giant sentinels always. Blow up. See this little kick that I'm doing? That was a little kick. That's my mini jump kick. That's my full jump kick. So you got a couple moves here. You can zap people on the ground. Wow, that one got a shot off. Are you kidding? Stupid stationary laser. Oh, look at this new color scheme on these guys. They got palette swap on these. pretty boys. Teal and orange. It's a good color combo for websites. Oof. These gun guys are actually one of the most dangerous enemies. At least I feel that way. Because they have a melee attack, they hit you with their gun, they also have their gunshot, of course. And they do a lot of damage. And they're very unpredictable.
It won't explode.
Now this fire actually hurts the enemies too, which I find hilarious. Because they walk on it, it hurts them. Come on guys, right here. Pretty clean work I'm doing right now. Now at this point I have 3 bars of life left. Some hits will just kill me now. And I don't want to die with that blue thing, so I kind of want to, if things get, you know, like, a good opportunity presents itself for me to use my power, I definitely want to be using it. So I use it there. It's a fair use. I killed a good amount of guys. Storm is, I think, one of the best characters in this game because she has a little extra reach because of her baton. So she can kind of hit people before they're in range to hit her sometimes. Look at the range of this jump kick. It's insane. Colored sentinel. Come on, boys. Come on. Baloney. Head first. This game was pretty high property back in the day at Chuck E. Cheese type places. Me and my friends would play this a lot. It's usually like a big 6-player machine. And it's pretty fun because like kids would trade off and they join in and help each other, you know? And then, you know, kids would come and go. But like they get further and further in the game as kids would put quarters in. So a lot of times like a group or part of the remnants of a group would like pick up, you know, an old group's progress. So you, like they would all die off on level 4, and then you pick it up at level 4, and then kind of carry it on. So it was pretty cool. A sense of community in that game. That's a good shot right there. It's a good, meaty superpower. Oh, shit. God. That lightning hurts you. Oh, wow. He usually gets hit there. Well, okay, that was dumb. Lobby just spam powers on him, so why don't you just hit him twice? You do 2 combos and you just put him on his ass. A beating. Down. And then I'll get my life back and I'll get 1 more special power back, so it's a pretty easy boss. Only died twice.
X-Men.
Death per level. I'll beat it in no time.
Magneto. However, we had time to locate their base on Island M. Destroy it!
That's weird that Magneto, Magneto was with Xavier. Or is it because Xavier's kidnapped? Is that what's going on? I'm not really following the story, so. Now in this level we've got these alligators, which have this really cool jumping attack. This tail whip, there it comes. He got me. Jump attack. Stupid alligator. There's these enemies I want to show you guys coming up pretty soon here. Come on, you stupid. A bit of a beating right now. Nah, couldn't get away. Died with a special power in my hand. That's really sad. Look at all these guys, wow. Oh, so juicy. Here, these flower guys. They put these guys in this game. This is the only time they appear in the whole game. Those three flower guys right there. I don't even know what they do when they hit you. I don't know how they even attack. Because that's it. Somebody had to animate those guys to be like in this tiniest cameo in this game. It's so weird. They don't get any love. Alright, I gotta use my special power pretty soon here. Okay, that was really smooth for the bees. Stupid alligators. Smartass. Yeah. Zap that alligator. There it is, the best line.
X-Men, welcome to die.
Welcome to die. That's classic Magneto right there. Excuse me. Really, why are these guys so pixelated? Like, it looks like they're a little guy that got enlarged. Who is this?
Windigo.
I mean, he screams his name Windigo, but who the hell's Windigo? Ah. Yes. Zero deaths on Windigo. This is money. I'm impressed with how well I'm doing right now.
Go and rescue Kitty from the cave.
Oh, look at these beauts. Iron Man flavor. Iron Man flavor sentinels. These losers again. Look how pixelated they are. Like, what was I saying? It's like they're small, and then they enlarge them and make them huge. But, like, why don't they just draw them full size so they don't look terrible? Look at these guys. Oh, teamwork, huh, boys? Oh my god, these two guys are clean. Okay. Thank you. this pro gaming right now. I'm doing like combo action. Gotta do it.
Oh no.
I died. Perfect though. Oh, wow. Car fell on me. Storm did not see that coming. That's so cheap. Oh, I just dove into those guys. Button mash. There's not really much to this game. Like I said, you got this little jump kick, you got your big jump kick, and that's about all. But it's really fun. You know, you might say this is funner with two people. I mean, it definitely is. It's fun with a friend. But the arcade machine was made with three screens. It's called the X-Men 6. And it was huge. I've seen a real one. I almost bought it, actually. When I used to work at my pizza place, there was an arcade retail, like our arcade seller. Oh my god, look how many. There was an arcade seller, and they would rent arcade machines out to like state fairs and stuff. And they sold some. And I went in there once to like check out what they had. And they had the X-Men 6 machine for sale. $500. I was like ready to buy it. And then my dad's like, well, where the hell are you gonna put it? And I took its measurements and I was thinking about it, and it's about the size of a car. It's a car. I mean, you look at it in the front and it's just like a pretty big arcade, but it goes back. Like those TVs, it's three giant bulb TVs. On top of the fact that it weighs like a ton, it's just so big. Like it wouldn't fit in my garage. It wouldn't fit in the basement anywhere, and if anywhere it would fit, it would like dominate the area, like it'd be the whole room. Like it'd have to be like an arcade room, you know, that was just the X-Men machine. But anyway, the three screens make the game so much bigger that you can actually play it, you know, with a lot of people. Like if I put two people on this screen, yeah, it would be like almost too crowded. It's not as great as it seems. I mean, it's still very fun. Problem is, I don't have any friends that are as good at this game as I am, so they would just kind of eat all the credits. Unless we both have separate credits, then they could just fail. Oh no, more boulders. Not the boulders. Sentinels. Have mercy. Another boulder. No, a boulder hit me! Look, I'm not saying the boulders can't hurt Storm. I'm just saying it's kind of silly that they bring rocks when they're like robots. I mean, what would a Sentinel cost? Let's think about it. What would be the cost of one Sentinel? Like, what's one airplane cost? Like one big stealth bomber. It's like $2 billion. What would be a Sentinel? Like, it's gotta be, each one has to be, even if they perfect it, it's gotta be at least $200 million, right? Okay, here we go. See my extra range. I'm pretty sure Storm's extra range is what the secret is, but I had zero times on him. I have these bosses, I'm cutting through them. Just cutting through them. I mean, the real key to this game is you have to use your mutant power. You have to. Because when you're low on life, you gotta spam it. Otherwise, you'll die and you'll lose it. Like, if there's like six guys on the screen and you are trying to save it, they'll kill you and you'll lose it. Or you kill them, and then you like those six guys won't kill you anymore. You make your lives last so much longer. That's the biggest lesson you can learn in this game, is don't conserve your special power. You're always better dying like on empty. Look at these new color scheme, I didn't even notice. Silver green flavored. Oh my god, it almost knocked me off the fucking cliff. I was so scared. Okay, no, that's easy. Take it easy. These are like the black belt sentinels. Is that what we're dealing with here? Oh, this guy again. So easy. They're easier to kill than Sentinels. There's a ridiculous sprite animation on them. Oof, my queen just gutted me. Alright, queen. my last hit. She just gets some vulnerability on it. Sit down. Stay there. Oh, you think you're bad? You ain't bad! Whoops. Whoops. Screw that up. Not bad work. Oh, okay. Like centaur cyborgs, half man, half machine. Oh, I mean, the amount of sentinels you gotta kill in this game. Like I said, if there are $200 million a sentinel. And why are they working for Magneto? Wait a minute. Why are the sentinels working for Magneto? That never happened.
Juggernaut will flatten you.
Oh, Jesus. Fuck, Juggernaut. Take it easy, buddy. Sit down, Jugs. Sit down and stay seated. Haha! One death on Jugs. Look at me, 20 lives left. I own this game with $202.50. You know, when I was a little kid, this game was impossible. Now I'm like, kind of walking through it. I'm a little bit impressed with myself, to be honest. Oh, look at these Silver Surfers over here. These must be the Black Belt. The Black Belt guys. I gotta kind of get in there. I'm just gonna go ahead and blast. Oh shit, I'm walking to the edge. That is real lava down there. You will die. Oh, I threw him off the edge. That's awesome. I'm gonna be a little liberal sometimes with those, yeah. All of the pyros in the world. Shut up, Pyro. Idiot. Stupid car guys, huh? Come here! Yeah, so what was I saying? Magneto won Sentinels? I mean, Magneto was against the Sentinels. Now Magneto's leading a Sentinel army. I mean, the whole Sentinel thing is because the humans made them to fight the mutants. Oh, just took these guys alive. Oops. Okay. Dead. Thank you. range these guys. Boom. It's weird that you fight two, and then you fight one. This one's got laser beams. Cornered. You're cornered by Storm. Good game. Oof. Get in the corner, you bitch. Oh, okay. I see how it is. Who's the boss? Who's the boss? It's Storm. X-Men. Kitty Pryde is in the...
X-Men.
We rescued Kitty Pryde.
Magneto is planning to attack Earth from his asteroid base. You must foil his plan before it's too late. Go after the giant sentinel.
Oh, I'm following the last sentinel. Or is it the giant sentinel? Is that what I'm following? Oh, Asteroid M. Here we go. Oh, wow. Look at these guys. These are the real prestigious sentinels. Made out of solid gold. Gold, is gold a bad or a good conductor of electricity? Because that would affect Storm in a negative way if they're a bad conductor, wouldn't it? I still got my beating stick, though, so not that bad. Alright, guys, it's enough. Wow! Okay. Wow. Okay, that was a good use of power. Whoa, guys! You little turd. Oh! Thought I killed him. Here you go. Oh, hello. This part's hard because if you walk too far, you start getting other bosses to come out. You don't want to do that. I'm telling you, Storm's extra range is super abusable. Get up. Sit down. Oh. Next. You. This is Magneto, but not the real Magneto. Come on now. Alright, I'll die. Get up. Get up, Magneto. Oh yeah? Mystique! Bitch! Jennifer Lawrence! Good time to drink.
Alas,
juice.
That was Mystique, not Magneto. Magneto is at another place.
go.
Magneto is in another castle.
Alright.
I am Magneto, master of magnet.
Dead. Master of magnet himself. Chicken.
Kill. X-Men, come to... Dead. You are dead.
Zap. Well, I got like enough lives just to kill him with my storms alone. This is funny if you can get here with Wolverine, because if you know, you know Wolverine, Magneto can just suck all the his bones out. So this won't be much of a fight at all. So I'll die. Look, I can trade all day. Sit. What are you messing with, Mags? With 11 lives to spare? Talk about your pro gaming. Easy game. Easy game. Note, the game is not over yet. I always wonder about that. I think it's just because I have quarters in there. Like, I have quarters, so what are they gonna do? Take them? They don't let me play the game again. Except for the credits roll, the game just restarts, and you get to replay it, but I'm not going to do that, obviously. Although I could do it with a different character. They don't even let you pick the character, you're just back in a storm, I think. Which is, pretty sad. Well, there it is. Looks like the $5 gamer made short work of the X-Men arcade game. A game I originally thought was impossible to beat with less than $20. So... thanks for watching. If you have any ideas for the other games you want me to play, please let me know, and I'll give them a shot. Have a good day.